speedo on this as it swung up. What it do, gang? It's your little homie, Elko Warren, and you know we up in the rock shop. All right, y'all, we getting it together, getting it well in hand, man. Yes, sir, I got the other video going. You guys now know the Holley is out. Well, Holley is still in it, but the Holley EFI on this car is done. We're gonna save that for a different project. We had a couple of issues started popping up, nothing major, but I really need to get this thing going, moving on its own power, and sitting on the phone with Holley and all of that stuff. But no, what was going on, gang, is I'm going to say this is a user error problem because it started popping up once the voltage started dropping. So my alternator wasn't charging, so I dove heavy into the world of alternators and I figured out what was going on. This is a Tough Stuff one wire alternator. It's brand new, but it sat on that shelf over there since like 2013, somewhere around there. I had another one and the thing was beautiful. It's one wire. You don't hook any wires up other than the charging wire. And it, once you get up to a certain RPM, let's say like 800 to 1000 RPM, boom, it self excites and it starts doing its thing. This one sat forever because, gang, I actually had walked away from G-bodies or just from cars. All the projects sat in here for years. I didn't even go through the garage. I just walked all the way away from it. And my homeboy, T-Top Tony, my brother from another mother, him and my son, they pulled me back into the wonderful world of G-bodies and working on cars, you know, just old schools, period. So I actually walked away from it. And they brought me back into it. I was actually going to sell the SS, the whole nine, man. I just was done. This sat for years at a yard. And then, of course, this one wasn't here yet. And the Malibu was just in storage. So, but yeah, gang, so it sat for years. And it lost its ability to self-excite. And so I had to read up on it a little bit more. And this one, you can either do the one wire, or you can wire it up in this conventional way. So this whole front pulley came with an alternator that had the plug on it. And that plug from GM Performance is like $70. So I had to dig through here and I found it. And learned a little bit about it, how to wire it up, what each letter stood for and how to get it going. And learned a lot about how the SS was wired up, how it was all jacked up, why something that was going on, I couldn't get that alternator, a brand new alternator, to charge. And I learned a lot. So I think the whole Holley situation started with the charging system. If the car is not charging properly, nothing's going to work right over time. So I burnt out a fuel pump, and then we were having other issues. And I said, you know what? Until I get this issue figured out, I'm going to go ahead and remove it. So we removed it, and now we are back to the Holley Street Avenger, Ultra Street Avenger. This is the one that was on the blue Elko, and you can still see a little bit of the blue metering block on the bottom. I painted all of this up in here silver, real clean. This is way too much carb for this. This motor originally came with a 670 CFM carb. We did some upgrades to it, you know, long tube headers. We did Holley or Edelbrock RPM air gap intake, and that's as far as performance stuff goes. But this is a 770, either a 700 or 770 CFM. Too much, it's a little rich, but she's firing up. We stabbed in the HEI setup, got that going. And we've only done the initial timing. We haven't done total timing yet because, you know, I'm still going through and making sure that everything, there's no leaks, there's no fuel leaks. And we good. We got no fuel leaks so far. Pressure's coming up, doing what it needs to do. And this is going to be a true, what is this? Going to be a true cold start. And let me go ahead, you know, now that we back to the carbs, you gotta hit the hit it two times to get some fuel up in there. And so we also did the gauges. I messed up the brain on the other gauges, so I had to put in these. This is another vintage set, gang, from 2013. Just sat new in the box. So we got it wired up right quick. We still haven't wired up the, yeah, there we go. See, it's coming on blue. We still have not wired up the, what do you call it? The oil pressure and temp, but I know that the oil pressure is coming up on this, no problem. And so let's see what we got. That boy, she is doing the damn thing. She ready to do her thing, gang. And that's what I needed. I needed to get this back in its, you know, so we can get it on its own, moving on its own power. And we there now. So we got the alternator is charging. And what I ended up doing, gang, is I wired the alternator up as a two-wire setup, so three wires, so that the charging wire, then there's a wire that goes from the stator to the hot lead, and then there's an exciter wire. See, I don't have the exciter wire, and the way they had it wired up at the shop when this was put together by the shop and the SS, they wired it up incorrectly. The way that alternator was wired up, it needed... The way they wired that alternator up works on this alternator. But what I ended up doing, gang, is I depinned and repinned it. And then I ended up putting a charging light. Because if you have battery power going straight up to the alternator in the plug, you'll end up burning the solenoids or whatever it is that's up in there. You end up burning them out. So you need a resistor in there, a 50-ohm resistor or a 194 bulb. And so that's what I ended up putting in line. So off the exciter wire, off the harness, there's an exciter wire. So it runs through a, you know, 194 bulb, kind of bulbs that go here. So I had a couple of extra sockets. So I wired a bulb into it just to test it out. And the theory is when you turn the key, you know how on the newer cars, when you have the battery light, when you turn the key on, when it senses the battery is, the alternator is charging, the light goes off. If that light comes back on, that's telling you your alternator is no longer charging. So I was like, this should work. This is going to do it. So I went ahead and turned the key. And you see my light is on in there. Somewhere in there, you can see the light. So let me see if I can get this situated. Sheesh, I can't get situated. All right, so you see the reflection of the light right there. So what we'll do is that we'll turn the key, and once it turns off, you'll see the voltage shoot up. So the voltage right now is under 13 volts, probably at 12.6. See the reflection of the light right there? And then I'll show you what the volts look like. So as soon as I turn it, the RPMs will go up, and that light will turn off. And the volt shot up. See that? There we go. I'm gonna have to let this thing eventually warm up, but we still are, you know, checking stuff, make sure everything is good. That fast idle is like crazy high. I'm gonna have to do a little research and see how I can get that to kick down a little bit lower, you know, because it's a cold start. But yeah, gang, so there it is. I'm gonna want to show you guys the cold start that, boom, we own. Every time I turn that key, she firing right up. Let's see if we get another start. Probably need some gas in there. Yeah, we need a little bit of gas in there. Now, there is something that I'm going to be adding later on. I don't think I really need to. The owner's not really tripping off of it. But it'll do the same thing that the Holley EFI does. When you first turn the key, it primes the pump. And the pump, you know, sends a buzz up to the throttle body. And you get the four bulbs get fuel so that you can start it right away. Well, I have a module that does the same thing with carburetors. but I would have to switch it all over back to EFI. So like a Holley Blue or something like that. So when you turn the key, the module buzzes the fuel pump, and then the fuel pump sends like 5 seconds worth of fuel. So it's the equivalent of you pump, pump, tap, tap, tapping. Same thing. So I asked the owner if she wants that. She's not really tripping. You know, tapping the gas a couple of times. I'ma cheat it. I'ma hit the kick down. Whoops, I kicked it down too soon. But yeah, gang, so there it is. She's doing great. Yeah. Doing a little cleanup in here, gang. Finding stuff, cleaning everything out. Because it's almost time to get that drive shaft cut. Time to get that drive shaft cut and get this thing out of the garage and get my Malibu in here. So all of this has got to get put up somewhere, get cleaned out. I don't want nothing around the Malibu. So that's what we out here doing now, gang. But anyway, man, just a quick little something to show y'all. The girl is still out here doing her thing. All right, let's see if we can get another start. I'm afraid to let her fast idle like that until I look everything over. Good. Let's see what we idling at. We're idling at about 950 right now because it's still cold. Probably too low. Yeah, it's about 600. Alternator is charging. Can't see it. Oh yeah, we're like at 14 point something volts. Should get my little volt meter out. See what it do. Oh yeah. Oh yeah, gang. Now me, I like how beefy it sounds. It's got those thrush welders on it. It's basically this setup right here. Oh yeah. So yeah, gang, I'm gonna get this Ooh, she is rumbling. No shaking. Let's see what the 720. I'm gonna turn that up just a little bit, gang. I want it about 750 around there. Still not still not warmed up. I think that's it right there. Yep, 760, 770. That's where I like it, right there. But anyway, gang, just wanted to show y'all cold start, man. She is, her initial timing is done. We still need to get a timing light on it to see what the timing actually is. I'm thinking it's around 10, 12 is where this motor really likes it, but 10 is what the factory wanted you to put it at when it was under warranty. But 12 is where this motor really likes to do its thing. And then we got to get the total timing. So once we get that, you know what? Shit, I don't know how much gas I got in here. But anyway, gang, just wanted to show y'all, man, we out here getting things cleaned up, getting the rock shop together, getting backyard ready, almost ready to put her high heels on and getting traffic, gang. She about to be outside. Yes, sir. All right, we gonna see what she charging up at.
14.4.
Yes, sir. We are looking good. So that wiring job worked out great, gang.
Yeah.
Quick fade in, gang, before I head into work. Went ahead and we got the, after work last night or this morning, I got the sensor swapped out. So we have the correct sensor for the Dakota Digital in there. That when I had to run an adapter on it, you know, the package, it comes with a gang of adapters. And then we went ahead and swapped out the oil pressure sensor. This setup is way different from the original one. The original one, you just ran a wire, and I left those wires in there, man. It's just a pulse or whatever. It grounds it. I don't know what it does, but it's not something that's like electrical. But it sends, you know, the signal on up, and you just attach it to the sending unit. This actually has a different, you know, two different wires. You got to program it, and I don't know if I did all that. So, you know what? I might not have to. You know, with carbs, you got to bump the gas a little bit. The fast idle, I got to adjust the fast idle on this, and it's a bitch to get to by yourself. All right, that should be enough. On another note, man, I got all that gas up out of here using this right here, gang. Yeah, from Harbor Freight. So all that fuel was in this tank. It's probably got just a little bit more because, you know, it's baffled and whatnot. But, yeah, I got all that out. So we'll be able to use that petrol. But let's see. Hopefully I get the oil pressure and temp. I'm so used to seeing the digital, you know, the actual numbers. But, yeah, let's see what we get. If we can get this thing to fire up. You know, let me take this air cleaner off. I got to get this all redone. All right. That way I can get to the fast idle cam, which is this little orange piece right here. Yeah. But yeah, I need to adjust that down. It's just a bitch. You need a really short screwdriver to get to it, and you need two hands. You need two people to get it done. Let's see. Fire it back up. Yeah, that fast idle was crazy high. Crazy high. Give him two squirts. That's what I miss about that EFI setup. Let's see what we got over here. There it is. Oil pressure went up. Yes, sir. Right there. Oil pressure is good. Battery is damn sure good. And now we just need to see if the temp is gonna work. See, as I adjusted the float, see how the butterfly's moving? Trying to see if I get that temp to come up. Yeah, I gotta get that fast idle going, but today is cold as hell. But it was nice to see, gang, that that temp or oil pressure went up. So we got that hooked up. Whoo, man, it's rich. Yeah. Now that we got this thing charging, I want to throw that Holly back on, but the young lady said no. She not with it, so we'll save it for later. We still need to set the timing. It's just initial timing so we can get it to start. So we can get it to start.
that door up. It smells like straight fuel over here.
There we go, gang. So, you know, let me hit it one more time. Starting to get some heat in it, so let me see if hella cold in here, gang. The fast light, though, I guess isn't that bad. It's nice and, yeah, it's responsive. It's just hella gassy, so I'm gonna have to let it run for a little bit to see if that temp gauge is set up right. See, I'm used to the digital one right now, it would give me a readout. But the needle on this hasn't swung up. Make sure the alternator's charging. Ray, I know right away when the alternator's charging because the light goes off. Yeah, we idling at 760. I was hoping I can get this temp to go up. But there we go. See, idling at about 780. Definitely charging, gang. Oh yeah, we at up down there at 15 volts. All right, so that's a win. I just need to see that. Okay, the needle is starting to go up. Yeah, needle starting to move up a little bit. I think we're gonna be running out of gas here in a minute. But yeah, the fast idle cam, gang, the way you get to the adjustment is you gotta take the throttle, open it all the way up, and up underneath on this side there's a little screw there that you make the adjustment. Clockwise gives it more, counterclockwise gives it less fast idle. This thing fast idle is down there at 3000, so I need to adjust that. This whole carburetor is way too big. Like they gonna be chasing me up out of work because I smell like raw fuel right now. It's way too much carb. Yeah, it's finally starting to move, gang. I'm just gonna let it idle on out. I'm gonna make sure we ain't got no situation. So far, gang, no leaks. I'm really happy about that. You know how the old schools be. They always got a leak or two somewhere. But so far, gang, we are looking good. And you know, always on deck, gang. Always on deck, close by. Yes, sir. Hey, the homies be on my head about when you gonna be out, when you gonna be out. Man, don't worry about when I'm gonna be out. I'm in here enjoying what I love to do, gang. I love running my mouth about these old schools. That's what I love doing.
And anybody that I can help, I don't do how-tos anymore, but anybody, even if it's just, man, if this 56-year-old dude can get up underneath that car and clean it, I definitely can get my 22-year-old self up there and do what he just did. You feel me? That's what my videos are for, gang. I don't do the whole how-tos anymore. You know, if you ask me and I know, I'll tell you. But yeah, gang, people be on my head about, man, when you going to be out? Don't worry about when I'm going to be out, gang. I'm out. I'm out in my garage doing what I love to do. But yeah, it is, man. Peeps be on my head big time, y'all. Okay, yep, temperature gauge is moving up. I got this rigged. I wanted to see if the fans are going to come on, but I'm going to turn them on right now manually. I got a little switch down here somewhere. There we go. But now the fans are on, but I'm going to leave them off because I want to see if they're going to come on by themselves. Oh, yeah, we got some heat in here now. We still got to set the initial timing. Our timing light hasn't been put on here. We just got it, you know, so we can get it started. But yeah, that temp's going up, gang. All right, so far, so good. We back, gang. We are back. All right, y'all. Man, I wanted to let this thing idle up, see if the fans would come on by themselves, because we don't have the Holley anymore. We're going strictly off of that sensor. I need to get these wires tightened back up. I had to reroute them. But yeah, so I'm trying to hide wires and, you feel me? Just slow it down so y'all can see everything and how it is. See what I mean? I made this pipe right here. Got it. I had it chromed out to make it look like a fuel rail, but it hides the wires. We'll get this cable management over here, you know, tightened up later. This is going to get sprayed up again up in here. I did port 15, but I did two passes, and the second pass messed it all up. We're going to go with vintage air, but I'm just going to put a plate on it for now. What we are trying to do, gang, is get this old girl out of the garage and get my Malibu here. So, man, for a homegrown backyard boogie, gang, I think this is coming together. Of course, you guys know about the, I got these done. And we got to get this loud exhaust off of here because it's going to drive her crazy. All right, we had 140. I'm not going to have time. I got to head into work, gang. But you see what it is. We getting it cracking. Get my little cover on there. Yes, sir. Most definitely got to represent 80s. But there it is, gang. It's your little homie up in the cleaned up rock shop. Well, we most definitely keep it shipping.